Game 6 of the Western Conference Semifinals here. Welcome, everyone, to the NBA Playoffs on 2K Sports. Tonight, it'll be the Utah Jazz going up against the Los Angeles Clippers here at the Staples Center. With Brent Berry and Greg Anthony, this is Kevin Harlan, and David Aldridge will be joining us on the sideline as well. D.A., take it away.
Good evening, Kevin. Well, last season, Paul George had a homecoming. He said, as a kid, I pictured playing in L.A., my parents being able to watch me at Staples. I'm not playing for the Clippers. This is home. I'm playing for the home team. It doesn't get any better than that.
And it's Gobert in at the five spot. And for Los Angeles, they've got Paul George. Paka is out there with Marcus Morris. Then there's Kawhi Leonard. And it's Beverly in at the one spot. So the Clippers win the tip. And it's Leonard at the elbow over Ingles. They get it back. And Ibaka slams it in.
And the ability to generate points off offensive rebounds, something Ibaka did a lot earlier in his career before he started spending so much time on the perimeter.
Now, here's Mitchell. Passes to Ingles. To Mitchell, six to shoot, and George gets the whistle that time. That is his first foul of the game. So it's Utah now. Conley finds Ingles. Back to Conley. Here's Ingles. Mitchell looking it over. From downtown, Utah gets it back. Gobert the pass to Mitchell. The dish to Ingles. Lock at six. Conley against George. And misses it off the right side of the rim.
Well, he's a guy they count on to produce from the mid-range. He doesn't miss too many open looks from there.
And the powerful frame of Morris, difficult to knock him off his rhythm and there finishing through the contact.
Here's Conley, following the basket by Marcus Morris. Pass to Ingles. Back to Mitchell, takes the three. The Jazz again can't hit it. For Los Angeles, they've gone 2-3 here to start out the game. Ingles against Leonard. Charity stripe shot, and it's the Clippers scoring again.
How about 3 of 4 from the floor to start? That's always a good sign.
Conley with it. Pass to Bogdanović. They could use a bucket. A shot's good on the assist by Ingles.
And the reliability of Bogdanović. His teammates know Bogey is good for that shot. So he gets the feed and sinks it.
Now, here's George. Good for the basket. Starting off 1 for 1 with that shot.
And early on, they've been nearly perfect from the floor. Just the one miss here on their first 5 attempts.
A pass to Gobert. Kicks it to Mitchell. And it's sent back by George.
Not many guys have the two-way ability of a Paul George, just as dangerous defensively as he can be offensively.
Defense doesn't get much better than the mobile one block we just saw on replay.
And it's a different kind of defense teams play in the postseason. More in your face, physical, high energy plays like that one.
About 3 minutes gone here in the first quarter. 5 on the clock. Ingles.
Such an elite defender. with unreal instincts, Kawhi Leonard, consistent at locking up whoever it is he's guarding.
And there it is for him.
This is as good as it gets for a first quarter in terms of shooting the basketball.
And here is Conley. Passes it to Gobert. Back to Conley. To Mitchell. The Jazz need to get off a shot here. For three, Conley's shot is off.
And you could tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
Here's Leonard. Lays it up and banks it in. Leonard's got 6 points.
And right now, they're just focused on putting together good possession.
That's exactly how they got the lead. They ended up having multiple possessions in a row with good quality shots, knocked them down, and the game is fully in their control.
Here's Conley. Kawhi Leonard making his last shot. Conley finds Mitchell. That's in there. Conley with the assist.
And there's an edge to Mitchell's game. He wants to be the guy in charge. And if that means he's got to get physical, he'll do it.
Now, here is Ibaka. Over Gobert. Ibaka, no luck.
The inside just a bit too congested for him to get the usual shot he would have with rhythm.
Now Conley. He's been patient so far. Nothing on the scoreboard yet. And now the Clippers on the break. Leonard with the ball. Ingles with the rebound. Jazz trail by 7. Mitchell in the corner. Over Jordan. Throws back up. Conley's shot is off.
That's the only kind of defense that's going to cut the mustard here tonight. You got to stay on top of a guy like that who can play at such a high level offensively.
Every time they get scored on during this run, it's come from inside the paint.
Timeout is called, first of the game for the Jazz.
And they're allowing too many points in the paint. Coach is going to let them hear about it.
Yeah, coach knows that. They know that. In the timeout, they're going to hear about it, make the adjustment.
And it's a completely new group for Los Angeles. So Utah going with an almost entirely new group here. Derek Favors checked in for Rudy Gobert. Ilyasova comes in for Bogdanović. Royce O'Neal's checked in for Joe Ingles. And it's Jordan Clarkson in for Donovan Mitchell. Conley against Rondo. Now, here's Clarkson. Tight defense on him.
And the offense early on limited to just jump shots.
Off with the layup.
And right from the start, Kevin, they've been pounding the glass. Most of those 50-50 balls also going their way. Really seizing the momentum of this game, but doing it with a methodical approach.
Well, how good have they been on the inside tonight, just getting down into the painted area and just dominating, controlling that spot.
Clippers leading by 11. Good work defensively by Conley.
For him, it's harder to miss that shot than it is to make that shot. I think he was anticipating a bit of a bump there.
Clarkson passes to Ilyasova. And it's blocked.
Maybe a time to rest him right now. Just give him a bit of a breather. Try to help him get back on track.
Excellent all-around performance so far. Hence the big lead.
Well, if I was baking up a lead, I'd add 2 ingredients. One would be playing smart. The other one, playing selfless. They've done that tonight. Serve it up.
Here's O'Neal. After the basket by Los Angeles. Back to Conley. 6 on the shot clock. 18 feet out. And that one hits back iron.
He just doesn't look like himself this quarter. Something's missing.
Well, he's missing, and it's starting to affect a little bit in his body language, and you just don't want to see that.
and you can't help but pick their defense apart. They're completely in disarray.
Clarkson taking his time here. Can they get it? Some solid defense there from Jackson. Los Angeles leading by 16. Bucket number three. He's a perfect three for three to start.
Well-rounded effort, and they show no signs of letting up.
Coaching staff probably most proud of the effort of this team on both ends of the floor here tonight.
Utah calls timeout.
And they just can't seem to get going offensively.
Yeah, they're like a four-day-old soda right now, just flat. They're missing shots left and right and just not playing their best.
George Niang, he's checked in for O'Neal. Conley against Rondo. Clarkson on the wing. Shot clock at five. From deep. But they'll get another chance. And Favors kicks to Clarkson. Fires the three. No good there. The Clippers go the other way with it.
They've been sensational on the backboard to start this game.
Jazz trail by 18. Pass to Ilyasova. Conley against Rondo. Ilyasova, no one around him. And a kind roll that time off the rim as that one falls.
That's a good example of the scoring mentality that Ilyasova has. When the ball comes to him, the first thing he checks is if he can get a shot up.
Now, here's Zubats. No points in the game yet for him. Rondo against Conley. Utah's gone a meager 1-6 from three-point land since we got started tonight. Seconds left to play here in the first. Favors dishes to Clarkson. No good. Some solid defense there from Jackson.
And the stroke definitely lacking confidence this quarter. Nothing on target.
Ilyasova passes to Clarkson. Count the bucket. And he's got a free throw coming up as well.
That is a tough move for Clarkson. Not the biggest guy on the floor, but making the biggest play.
Utah shooting their first free throw of the night here. Mitchell, he's checked in for the Jazz. Free throw good. Clarkson.
Clarkson, it's interesting for him. He's not really a point guard and not really a shooting guard, so trying to find ways to stay in the game and stay aggressive and do whatever is asked of him to earn minutes.
Outside Jackson. Here's the teardrop.
No escaping the outstretched arms of Ilyasova on that play. At every turn, he was right there and defended it well.
And an overpowering first quarter effort. Already a double-digit advantage. The Clippers on top. As they end the first quarter with a tremendous 17-7 run. We'll take a quick break, then get you back to the action. And always interesting to hear from Donovan Mitchell, who recently spoke about the team's progress.
Everybody had their expectations of what we should be or will be, but at the end of the day, you know, we got to be able to focus on us, you know. Obviously, we went through a little bit of a rough patch. You know, we're still figuring things out, but we can make adjustments and continue to build. And I think we're playing great basketball. I think we're doing things the right way.
And you know, Greg, Mitchell's going to be right in the middle of it, leading the way.
And on top of everything else he does, he's elite at getting his own shot. We've seen him carry this team offensively at times. Boy, he is special.
And we welcome you back to 2K Sports coverage of the Western Conference Semifinals. Guys, we've seen a competent-looking Clippers team out there.
Well, they used the fast break to generate some easy buckets before the defense could get set.
Yeah, they did a great job. Just the initial thrust of that attack as soon as they got the ball, constantly in transition.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, as the second quarter gets going. So on the floor for Utah, we've got Ilya Sova. Donovan Mitchell is out there with Jordan Clarkson. Then there's Favors, and it's Niang in at the three, the small forward. So it's Utah now. Rajon Rondo missing his last shot. Out of bounds, the Clippers take possession.
Yeah, the body language right now is not looking good for this basketball team. The game might be out of reach, but they have to avoid mistakes like that.
And the Clippers making a switch here. Leonard's checked in. The Jazz also changing it up. Gobert, he's checked in for Favors. Bogdanovich comes in for Ilyasova. And it's Joe Ingles in for Clarkson. Now, here's Kennard. He's still scoreless so far in this one. Now the pass to Zubats. He kicks it to Jackson. Lets it go from deep. Los Angeles with another miss. Jazz trail by 11. Mitchell outside. And it's Mitchell with the jam.
And you got to clog up those lanes. Mitchell just explodes to the rim when he gets to that launching pad.
Leonard against Bogdanovich. Passes it to Jackson. Back to Leonard. Good ball movement here by the Clippers. And the dunk by Zubats.
That is a product of pure effort, guys.
I agree, and that's nothing new coming from him, GA. He loves going to work on the rebounding, going to work on the board.
Stick with fundamentals there. Shot goes up, box out, or he'll destroy you.
Now, here's Ingles. Pass to Bogdanovich. Now, here's Leonard. And here in the second quarter of action with a hair under 2.5 minutes played so far. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
And I know they don't really want him to walk in there, but there's got to be some resistance on Cousins when he gets positioned that deep.
First trip to the free throw line for him in this one.
Shooting two.
And free throw good from Cousins.
Well, DeMarcus Cousins is so aggressive, he's always going to draw some fouls on the inside, whether the refs call that or not. Fortunately for the team, he's a very good free throw shooter.
Catching up on the changes for Los Angeles. Morris is checked in for Zubats. Paul George comes in for Luke Kennard. And it's Patrick Beverley in for Jackson. And so DeMarcus Cousins nails both of them. And so it's Mitchell who brings up the ball for the Utah Jazz, trailing by 13. Here in the second quarter, we've played a little over 2.5 minutes now. Outside, Bogdanovich. Just 5 to shoot. 20 feet out. That one dropped for his second bucket. Mark him 2 for 4.
And Bogdanovich dropping it in from there. He's so polished in terms of his ability to score.
O'Neal against Leonard. Back to George. Here's Cousins. Nice work on the boards, paying off with the basket. Cousins has got 4 points this quarter.
They have been board dominant in this game. That's definitely been a factor in crafting this huge lead.
Here's Mitchell. No good on the triple.
You know what, though? Sometimes you can be too open. I think it may have surprised him, and that's why he missed.
I didn't think there was a pass available there for Paul George, but he spots that small crease, he fires the ball through it, and he gets it to his open man.
Now, here's Mitchell. Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, right now, you just need a bucket to get some momentum.
Outside, Bogdanovich. And off the left side of the rim, and it swirls in for him. And that's now 7 points for Bojan Bogdanovich. Pass to Cousins. Feeds to George. Good. And it's Cousins picking up the assist.
They are just killing him on the interior.
Jazz trail by 15. O'Neal kicks to Mitchell. Morris with the block.
And this is what staying active can give you. Morris sending that one back with authority.
Beverly, the pass to Cousins. Over O'Neal. And again, the Clippers good for two.
Now, this story in the second quarter, much different than the one in the first. We're finally seeing some aggression.
And the Jazz call time here.
And they just can't seem to get going offensively.
Yeah, they're like a four-day-old soda right now, just flat. They're missing shots left and right and just not playing their best.
And the Clippers making a change here. Ibaka's checked in. And Utah also making a switch. Mike Conley's checked in for Mitchell. Here's Gobert. Good for the basket. Starting off 1-for-1 with that shot.
And using his insane wingspan and athletic frame, Gobert can flat-out dominate down low.
Now, here is George. And there's the pass to Leonard. Pulled the shot a little up, but the bounce goes his way. Leonard's got 10 points.
What a performance on the offensive end. He's making the defenders pay right now for all of the mistakes they're making.
Ingles against Morris. Out left to the wing. Here's Ingles. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. Count it. Clippers leading by 15. Beverly with the ball. And it's Leonard, top of the key. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
And we all know what a tough cover Kawhi has become. The defender got caught in a bad position and is kicking himself for it now.
This is his first trip to the line tonight.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And he makes the first.
It was a quiet intensity that Kawhi Leonard brings to both ends of the floor, a defensive menace. And it's amazing to watch him, just how disruptive he can be when he's guarding the 1, 2, 3, or even 4-man and messing up offensive scheme.
Looking at who's out there now for the Jazz. Derek Favors checked in for Rudy Gobert. Ilyasova comes in for Bogdanovich. And it's Jordan Clarkson in for Joe Ingles. Leonard hits them both.
Yeah, nice job of drawing the contact and creating opportunities at the line.
Beverly against Conley. Now, here's Clarkson. He's guarded closer.
Really good job on the timing of that cut into the lane. The speed that Clarkson has can be a problem for the defense.
Pass to George. It's hauled in by Ilyasova. Jazz trail by 15. Conley surveying the D. Offensive rebound. 2 points. That one goes. Favors has got his first bucket in this one.
Such determination on the glass. Not boxing out Favors is a huge mistake that you cannot afford to make.
Now, here is Morris. Leonard with the ball. Conley picks him up, and Morris throws it down.
and credit the screen for giving him the space he needed to get to the rim.
For sure, GA allows him to come in with the sledgehammer.
Yeah, well, you settle for the layup when you can attack the rim and rise up like that.
And the Jazz with possession here after the basket by Los Angeles.
And, well, he's been the NBA's leader in blocks multiple times. Ibaka just has that rare instinct for it.
That's good, and it's Leonard with the assist. Leonard's got his third assist on the night.
And Matador defense, that's one of the easiest shots he is ever going to see.
Yeah, feels like Christmas right now, just gift-wrapping points.
Clarkson finds Conley. Makes that one after missing his first six shot attempts. 1 for 7 and hungry for more.
And a little contact on the shot, but Conley with the laser focus on the finish.
And the Clippers decide to take their first timeout here.
And he could tell his guys were dragging a little bit, calling timeout to kind of let them catch their breath.
And Los Angeles with some changes. Zubac is checked in for Morris. Jackson comes in for George. Rajon Rondo subbed in for Patrick Beverley. And Utah with a change here, too. George Niang, he's checked in for O'Neal. And so Clarkson will bring it up for the Utah Jazz. 15-point game. They lost their last game on Tuesday.
Yeah, you know they wanted a few of those plays back. What a tough way to go out in that one.
Yeah, really a game that they should not have lost. But sometimes, even when you play your best, it might not be good enough.
He's gone 2 for 2 at the line so far.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
First one falls for.
Well, his body control is phenomenal, and his ability to get to the line has always been impressive. That's a huge part of his game.
Leonard hits them both. There's 1:38 left in the first half of the game. Pass to Favors. The Jazz working the ball around now. Clarkson against Jackson. Clarkson dishes to Conley. Here's Niang. And that one falls, coming off Conley's feet. Niang's got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three. To the middle. Here's Jackson. Utah with the rebound.
Well, you know, they're in the lead, but he's still been frustrated from an offensive standpoint.
And the call on the shot that sends him to the line. That's on Reggie Jackson.
You got to be cautious when you guard Clarkson. He's got a good burst. And when he gets assertive like that, oftentimes will draw a foul.
He made the only free throw attempt he had earlier in the game. First free throw is good. Kennard, he's checked in for the Clippers. And both free throws good for Clarkson.
And that's the norm for him. He's pretty much automatic when he's at the line.
Jackson passes to Rondo. 44 seconds left to play here in the half. And a missed layup. Jazz trail by 12. Here's the break. And no one near Clarkson as he lets it go. That's in there. Conley with the assist. Conley's got his fifth assist in this one. Los Angeles has gone 0-2 from deep here in the second. Rondo kicks to Zubac. There's 21 seconds left in the first half. Here's Jackson, stolen by Clarkson. And now Utah, fast break. Here's Favors, and foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
And with deceptive speed and a lengthy wingspan, defenders can sometimes just get stuck fouling Favors.
For Utah, they have made 3 free throws so far. Haven't missed any. The first one falls. And so Favors nails both of them. And so it's Los Angeles heading to the bench with a 7-point lead as we wrap up the quarter. They've been playing some ferocious defense. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thank you, Kevin. Here with Coach Quinn Snyder. Quinn, what concerns you most about the first half?
Well, I think the tempo is in their favor right now. They're fast, and they're getting up and down the floor. So they're running out in transition.
Got to beat him to the punch. Thanks very much, Coach. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks, David. And we'll be back shortly following halftime to get the third quarter underway.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Well, you will not find an empty seat here tonight. Welcome to our halftime show. Ernie Johnson, Kenny the Jet, Shaquille O'Neal. You looking for an empty seat?
Yeah.
You're sitting
in. It's only 3 of us.
Went and the seats are all full.
Okay. Oh, you meant in the arena.
That's what I'm talking about.
Checking out the Clippers, they clearly can sense how close they are to wrapping up the series in 6 games. They'd love to close it out here and avoid a game 7. What'd you think, Shaq, about the first half we saw from the Clippers?
The claw is stealing the show, proving the value of load management. And explosive, playing with high energy, playing at an MVP level. Wow, the claw.
And Kenny, let's get your input on the Jazz.
Their 3-point shooters struggle to get into a rhythm. It's a mental thing. You start clanking them and your teammates start. It's contagious. Now, percentage-wise, shooting in the low 30s, it's not horrific, but it's not great. And they have to improve their accuracy from deep in the second half, or they're going to have a hard time coming back.
And it's just about time now for the third quarter to get underway.
And we're back. Good to have you with us for 2K Sports coverage of Game 6. Kawhi Leonard really has his fingerprints all over this one.
Yeah, it's been a great performance from him, really staying focused on quality shots.
Yeah, this is showing that they're not going to play at anybody else's pace but their own.
We played through the first half. Plenty of basketball, though, left in this one. And so it's Bogdanović who brings up the ball for the Jam. They trail by 7. Marcus Morris is out there with Ibaka. Then it's Paul George. Then it's Patrick Beverley. And it's Leonard in at the small forward position. That's who's out there for the Clippers. Here's George. Michael Conley making his last shot. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Michael Conley. That's foul number 2 for him. Let's take another look at the staunch defense during that mobile 1 block.
And bringing that postseason intensity, so key. These plays can change the trajectory of a game.
And here is Ibaka. Dishes to Leonard. That one falls through. It's his sixth make from the floor this game. Now 6 for 10.
That's Kawhi pushing the action all by himself there, attacking inside and starting to take charge.
Conley, the pass to Mitchell. For Beverly. And it's Mitchell missing.
Another rebound hauled in. They're hitting the glass with a lot of passion.
And that one's good. Beverly.
Beverly plays with such great confidence, and it's clear he believes in his ability to score off the pass.
Up top, Gobert. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot 2 free throws. Serge Ibaka picks one up there.
And with the offense getting right to the rim, at least they saved the layup.
The Jazz shooting their 6th and 7th free throw attempts tonight.
Shooting 2.
First one falls for.
An improved free throw shooter compared to his earlier seasons. Nice to see Gobert attack his weakness.
And Gobert drops them both. Here in this third quarter, just over a minute play. Leonard against Ingles. Puts one up from 19. Clippers working now with the new shot clock. And he'll shoot free throws here. Clearly fouled on that shot that time. The whistle blowing.
So difficult to defend Ibaka inside. The length, the improved strength, and he's one of those bigs who doesn't mind going to the line.
The Clippers have made all of their free throws so far tonight, going 6 for 6. And the first one drops.
And no matter what, one of the big positives they can take away from this game is how well they performed at the line.
And both free throws good for Serge Ibaka.
Well, a big fellow with the ability and confidence at the free throw line is something that every team wants. Don't have to make those late substitutions. Keep your big guys on the floor.
Now, here's Mitchell. The Jazz with another miss.
A good job by him on the glass here tonight. +8 in that department.
I know it's about defending the post and the three-point line these days, but still got to be active in the mid-range area, and the defense gets away with one there.
Ingles against Leonard. Ingles dishes to Mitchell. Looking to get it going, and it's good on the way in. Mitchell's got 6.
One of the more powerful young guards in our game. Mitchell loves to attack the heart of the defense.
Leonard, that's for 2. He hits the back iron and sinks the shot. And the Clippers lead by 9.
And obviously his momentum from the last game has carried over here tonight.
Yeah, the coach pretty smart for zoning in on him and giving him opportunities to stay with that confident play.
And the Jazz call time here. You have to like what we're seeing so far from Kawhi Leonard.
Yeah, the defense has not provided any threat to stop him out there, so it should come to no surprise that he continues to attack the basket.
Not quite 2.5 minutes played here in the second half. And Gobert kicks to Conley. Shot clock at 6. Gobert with a wide open look. A three-pointer off the mark.
And hard work on the glass. Once again, guys, they put a lot of effort and focus on the backboard.
Beverly against Conley. Beverly feeling it out a bit. Looking for Ibaka. He gets it there. Lays it up and in off the pretty assist. And it's an 11-point Clipper lead.
A good job of reading the pick and roll there from Patrick. You give him a passing lane. He's going to get to it.
Mitchell passes to Gobert. Conley dishes to Mitchell. Here's the three. He can't get it to go. So Los Angeles will take it the other way. They led by as many as 18 points. Leonard, no luck. Jazz trail by 11. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively for sure.
And so George will bring it up for the Clippers. Their defense has only allowed 6 points in the second half.
Oh, great ball movement there.
Utah has gotten blank from three-point land so far in the third. Still 0-3. And it's sent back by George.
Just not much success when it comes to shooting.
A nice shot by Bogdanovich.
Well, maybe he's thinking at this point, man, somebody's got to help me. I can't do this all by myself.
Outside Leonard. Back to Beverly. Outside, George sinks the three-pointer. George has got 7.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Conley, the pass to Bogdanovich. Ingles kicks to Bogdanovich. Trying to answer back, but that three is off the mark. Clippers leading by 14. And here's Leonard from 3. Now, Ingles. Launches a 3. Knocks down the 3-ball. Ingles has got his 2nd bucket of the night.
And he's been passive today, but maybe that's what he needs to get him going, because for them to be successful, he's got to be a little more selfish.
And the Clippers call time here.
And he could tell his guys were dragging a little bit, calling time out to kind of let them catch their breath.
So Utah going with an almost entirely new group here. Derek Favors checked in for Gobert. George Niang comes in for Bogdanovich. Royce O'Neal's checked in for Joe Ingles, and it's Jordan Clarkson in for Mike Conley. Now here's Rondo. Outside Jackson. Count it.
He uses the threat of his drive to open up looks for him offensively. Jackson is one smart cookie.
Jazz trail by 13. O'Neal passes to Clarkson. Kicks to Mitchell. Pass to O'Neal. Favors at the elbow. The pass to Clarkson. And it's off from three-point range. Los Angeles leading by 13. Here's Kennard. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot 2. The Clippers have been a perfect 8 of 8 at the line. First free throw is good. The Jazz making a switch here. Ilyasova's checked in. That one falls, so he hits both of them. Jazz trail by 15. Passes to Mitchell. Over Rondo. the shot no good, a bit short.
And this feels like it's snowballed a little bit on them. The more he tries to shoot his way out of this slump, the worse it seems to get. They need him to get it together.
It's easy to forget about Jackson's bunnies, but he's more than happy to remind you.
Pass to Favors. He kicks to Clarkson. Makes it off the glass. Clarkson's got 14 points for the game.
And say what you will about the value of the three-pointer, but those close-in looks are always plan A. Every trip down, get to the paint, get deep, score.
Now here's Jackson. 10 points for him. Here's Cousins, and he uses the glass on the layup. He's got 8.
I think this is where Cousins operates best. Comfortable using his size and comfortable in the painted area.
Pass to Favors. The Jazz working the ball around now. Mitchell outside. Over Rondo. And that one off the back of the rim and in. Mitchell's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Great mechanics from Mitchell on that one. You can count on him when he's at that range.
It's Jackson with the drive. Offensive rebound. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. This is his second trip to the line in this one. First free throw is good.
And if they continue, Kevin, their outstanding free throw shooting, that'll help them seal the deal.
George is checked in for Rajon Rondo. Joe Ingles is checked in for Utah. And so DeMarcus Cousins nails both of them. And here's Clarkson. He brings it up for the Jazz. 17-point game. Up top, Favors. He's guarded by Cousins. And looks like the illegal pick was set. Yep, that's right. That'll get their attention.
That's going to draw a whistle every time down the floor. Not even close to being a legal screen.
Yeah, everybody saw that one. That was pretty blatant there.
George against Ingles. And that one's good. George. George has got 9 points.
Yeah, Paul George anticipating contact, preparing for it, and just how smooth the finish was that, Kevin.
18 feet out, and it's Mitchell missing.
Well, they've been better than good on the glass today, and there is a glaring discrepancy between these two teams in that area.
Yep, that one goes in there. 12 points for him.
Hard to imagine them losing this game if they can keep shooting like that.
The wing, Mitchell, guarded by Jackson, and that one good from Clarkson.
Well, Clarkson can get inside. He's athletic to do that, and then needs the touch in that area. Showed it off there.
The pass to Jackson. Cousins inside. He's guarded by Favors.
He may not be the strongest inside presence in the league, but still, he's got to convert from there.
Kennard against Clarkson. Banked in off the glass. Clippers leading by 17. Now here's Jackson. He's got 12. Passes it to Cousins. Back to Kennard. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Takes a 3. Ingles with the rebound. Jazz trail by 17. And the shot goes down. Ingles has got 7 points in the game.
Now that play never gets old. The pick and roll will still be an offensive staple 100 years from now. Trust me.
It's a four-second differential between the shot clock and game clock. Here's Zubats. Nice spin off the left rim and in. Zubats has got his second bucket of the game to go. Here's Mitchell. He's got eight. Fires for three. And no good that time. And as we end the third quarter, a double-digit deficit will make it tough to come back. Los Angeles on top, leading by 17. And right after this, we'll bring you the start of the final quarter right here on 2K Sports. And let's take this opportunity now to show you our State Farm assist of the game.
And the definition of teamwork right there, guys. I mean, what great communication between them, and what a beautiful feed.
The coaches talk about it all the time, but to be able to play with that kind of feel, nice play, collaborating, improvising, and organic.
And one quarter to go in a game that to this point has not been an evenly fought contest. So on the floor for Utah, Favors and Gobert, the tough pair inside. Joe Ingles is out there with Conley, and it's Bogdanovich in at the threesome.
Well, you'd like to push Paul George out of the paint if possible. Goes into his bag of tricks to score that time.
Pass to Favors. Conley up top. He's covered by Leonard. They double-team Conley. Baseline Jay on the way. The rebound by Ibaka. Ibaka's got his sixth rebound on the night. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Jazz will take it. Conley against Beverly. Pass to Gobert. Over Ibaka. Favors trying to break free, and Gobert with the basket on the assist from Conley. Conley's got his sixth assist on the night. Conley against Beverly. Fourth quarter still young, just over a minute play. Leonard draws the double. Morris outside, just five on the clock. Here's Beverly. And it's off the back rim. No good. Jazz trail by 17. And the pass to Ingles. Bogdanovich looking around. Passes it to Favors. On the wing, Ingles. Defended by George. Ingles can't get it to go.
The shots like that drive coaches batty. I'll be shocked if he attempts that shot again.
Out to Ibaka. He dishes it to Beverly. Leonard against Favors. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up.
With those long arms and with the high release point, Leonard is practically daring you to foul him.
And he makes the first. Donovan Mitchell's checked in for Derek Favors. Leonard hits them both. Jazz trail by 19. They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
Conley against George. Bobbed up there for Mitchell.
Oh, Kevin, get a load of that one. Take that play and put it in the alley-oop textbook, boys.
Perfectly done. You're right. He put it on a platter for him. George looking around. To the inside. Leonard. And two free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the contact. It's going to be on Rudy Gobert. Throw drops for Leonard. Both free throws good from Kawhi Leonard. For those just joining us, fourth quarter here. We're just over 2.5 minutes into it. Mitchell with it. It's hauled in by the Clippers. Leonard's got rebound number 8 here tonight in the game. Stolen by Mitchell. One-on-one here. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. Mitchell's got 4 points now in the quarter.
He was sitting back a little bit there in the first half, but feels like showtime now, and he's ready to put some major points up on the board.
Los Angeles with another miss. Jazz trail by 17. And we're about 3.5 minutes into the fourth quarter. And here is Ingles. Here's Gobert, and foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line. Serge Ibaka picks one up there.
Yeah, the defender all over.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
And that one misses. He hits the second from the line. Here's Beverly. Now Leonard. And they call the foul, so a chance at the line for one more coming up.
That's the power and strength he brings. Kawhi able to absorb the contact. I'm not even sure he felt it and still knocks it down.
Free throw good from Kawhi Leonard. Jazz trail by 19. Pass to Bogdanovich. Back to Mitchell. Offensive rebound. Gobert. Good work defensively by Ibaka. And so it's Leonard with it. He'll bring it up for the Los Angeles Clippers. Here's Beverly. Rudy Gobert with the rebound. Gobert's got rebound number 9 now. What an effort here tonight. Morris against Mitchell. Here's Gobert. And there's the bucket. Stay with it on the offensive glass, getting it done. Gobert's got 5 points now in the quarter. Clippers leading by 17. Outside Leonard. Back to George. And Leonard has it in the corner. That falls. Nice feed that time from George. Leonard's got 16 points here in the second half. Now, here's Mitchell. Outside Conley. Mitchell up top, covered by Morris.
The aggressiveness of Mitchell, willing to take on the entire team to earn that foul.
Shooting 2.
Free throw drops for Mitchell.
And how fearless is Donovan Mitchell? I mean, as a rookie, in his first playoff series, he went off for 38 in a closeout game against none other than Russell Westbrook.
And good on the second, so he makes them both. Los Angeles leading by 18. And Beverly kicks to Leonard. Pass to George. He feeds it to Morris. Trying to get open is Ibaka. And there's Morris. That's good on the assist by George.
An efficient score inside. Morris can beat you with a variety of moves.
Mitchell passes to Gobert. Here's Mitchell. Gobert. It's good on the putback. And that's a double-double for him now. 11 points and 11 rebounds.
And, folks, he did not luck into that one. He knew just where he wanted to be to grab that backboard.
And Leonard gets it to go.
Down the stretch, he's been flat out awesome. He helped them get the lead, and now he's making sure they keep it.
Conley against Beverly. Here's Bogdanović. Tries again, and it's finished off inside by Gobert.
He knows his job. Gobert is there to own the glass and cash in on as many second chance opportunities as he can.
Stolen by Mitchell, and the Jazz pushing it up now. Not wasting any time and taking the shot and knocking it down. Mitchell's got 12 points in just the second half. Mitchell against George. Leonard looking around. Bogdanović grabs the miss. Jazz trail by 16. On the wing, Mitchell. He's covered by Leonard. Conley's shot is off. For Los Angeles, they've gone 5 of 10, 50% from the field. Ibaka finds Leonard. Ibaka with the ball. That's good, and it's Leonard with the assist. Leonard's got his fourth assist with that last one here tonight.
That's their third straight make off an assist.
Now, here's Mitchell. Utah calls timeout.
And they just can't seem to get going offensively.
Yeah, they're like a four-day-old soda right now, just flat. They're missing shots left and right and just not playing their best.
And now let's take a look at the New Balance player of the game, Kawhi Leonard.
And it's been a ridiculous performance in the best sense possible. I mean, everything about his game has been working. And no matter what they've thrown at him, he's had the answer.
Well, with the conference finals within reach, he was not going to let it slip away. Outside Conley, looking for Gobert. He gets it there. And slam dunk by Gobert.
Big night for Gobert. This team has become more and more comfortable leaning on his offense.
George against Mitchell. And so it's Bogdanovich who brings up the ball for the Jazz. They trail by 16. Mitchell's shot is good. Mitchell's got 10 points in the quarter.
Now, what a great option he gives them on every possession.
Beverly, the pass to Leonard. Over Ingles. Here's Zubats. And the shot is good. And the Clippers lead by 16.
Second chances are a great measure of what a team is doing in terms of their effort on a nightly basis. And that was some serious effort there.
Now, here's Mitchell. No one near Conley as he lets it go. And that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Zubats. Derek Favors checked in for Utah. Here's Mitchell. Favors inside. He's covered by Leonard. And that one drops.
And Bogdanovich, a talented scorer, likes getting involved down low.
Clippers leading by 14. Beverly, the pass to Zubats. Back to Beverly. Doubled by Conley. And the wide open shot from Morris. Rebound, Utah.
And I was sure that was money on that one, but everyone is afforded an easy miss or two.
Yeah, that happens. Important thing is for players, just don't beat yourself up and make a miss like that cost you another play.
And guys, just really impressed. They made big plays when it counted, and that's why it's going to be on to the next round for the Clippers.
Their shot blocking turned out to give them a big advantage in this game.
Yeah, excellent defense around the rim there, Kevin. That they were disciplined and focused.
And we watched one guy all night long, guys. And look at the stats, just confirms what a dominant game he had. What a night tonight it was for Kawhi Leonard.
He was extremely efficient offensively, got good looks, and really knocked down big shots all game long.
Now, here's George. Bogdanovich missing his last shot. George passes to Beverly. Back to George. Wants to get it to Zubats. And does. Four on the clock. Leonard draws the double. And again, the Clippers good for two.
Finishing strong. This is how you want to close things out.
Yeah, definitely putting a stamp on this one. A very, very decisive victory for the club tonight.
Mitchell outside. From past the arc, no good there.
Because of Paul George's athleticism, he can do a lot of things. He turns guys over, he blocks shots, he's got great hands. He affects a lot defensively.
So they've done it, they're gonna move on. A 4-2 victory for them in the second round. And now, they find themselves just 4 wins away from a spot, Craig, in the NBA Finals.
And it won't be easy. Conference Finals never are. I'm sure they're confident right now coming off of this huge win. But, Kevin, they've still got a lot of work to do before they put their hands on any trophy.
It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge. From